Hi everyone, welcome back to the Batlow planar cordon apple demonstration block, which is part of the Narrow Orchard Systems for Future Climates project. It's been about 3 months since our last video, which was just prior to Christmas. There hasn't been a lot happening in the block as far as operations go over that 3 month period. It's predominantly been about maximising the growth of the trees, with a little bit of tree training along the way just to keep them going where we want them for now. But now that we're sort of into well into autumn, growth is probably starting to just slow down a little bit now. We are starting to look at the next phase, which will be where the leaders are long enough to lay down those leaders to form the cordons. So we're starting to look at a bit of that now. Also having a bit of a play with the training system that we'll use for the verticals next spring when they start to come on. So just over the next few minutes, I'd like to share with you where we're up to, show you the block, and talk a little bit about what we're doing to try and keep these growing for now, and next steps. So over the last few months, just through the growing season, the only real operation here after we laid out our initial strings, with our angle that we wanted, it was just to keep running those shoots up those strings. And I think it's been two, maybe three passes through here with a tapener gun, just to apply some of this tape and keep the shoots on line with the angle that we wanted. So as I was saying, the last 3 month period, sort of from Christmas till now, towards the end of March, have been about getting these to grow as best as we could, keeping them growing so that we could get the length that we need in these verticals to then lay down and have the right cordon length. Some of the trees have made it, some are not going to make it this season, and we'll have to just continue trying to grow those on next spring. I'm standing in front of a particularly good specimen here, where I think we've got about 1.35 metres of vertical growth, which will be 1.35 metres of cordon when we lay them down, and being, you know, somewhere between these two wires is where we wanted them, and we know that they've got enough length now. So that's an example of one that's made it, and we don't need to do too much to that now, but we'll probably be here before these harden off too much for winter and put them down into that cordon position, which will be another video. So moving along, here's one that's not quite reached that height that we want. It's still growing, and we're going to leave that alone and keep the water and nutrition up to it through the last bit of March and into April, and see if we can't get the length that we need on those. And there's quite a few at that height which are almost there. And then we have some like these, where one of the leaders is quite close to where we want to be, and one is not quite there and needs to grow on a fair bit before it'll reach the height. So what we've done there, and you can see in the background, and I've got one behind me, we've taken the leader that has made the height that we're looking for and partially laid it down for now to take some of its apical dominance away and hopefully drive some late season growth into the remaining verticals. So that's just a temporary measure. That's not the final position of those cordons at all. They're too upright at the moment, so they'll come down quite a bit further once we see if we can get the growth into that other vertical. And if not, they'll be laid down this winter anyway, those ones that have made length. So there's a few of those. I've been through the block today and selected those that needed to be trained down to give that other vertical a chance to grow on with the remaining growing season. There's another one there. I'm hopeful we'll come back, as I said, with a bit of nutrition maintained and a bit of good watering over the next month. We might be able to capture some late season growth on these and get close to our final height. But overall, the block's looking good. There will be some trees, as I say, that we have to deal with getting the cordon length right next spring, but you know, that was always going to be the case with the variable stock that we had from the nursery. But all in all, it's going quite good. Interestingly, back in at the end of December, our last video, at that time, Jeremy and I noticed that there were a number of our verticals that were terminating at that stage, and we were very concerned that the trees looked like they might have been going to park up. Anyway, as it turned out, with a bit of rainfall and again continued irrigations and fertilisers, those buds that were terminating fired up again, and we've ended up with quite a reasonable growth across the block. And it's only just now that we're starting to, end of March, that we're starting to see some buds starting to terminate once again. So that's it for our update on the planar cordon block at Batlow. The next video will be very much on the process of laying down the leaders to make the cordons, and by then we'll have consolidated our thoughts on the vertical training system that we'll use. So stay tuned for the next video, where we'll look at the cordon establishment. Bye for now.